welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Game one of the American League Division Series. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Thunder. Alongside my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us here. Game one is always critical in a postseason series, Singy.
Yeah, and this is when you love having home field advantage, Boog. If you capture game one, you're full of confidence that you've got a chance to ride that momentum for the rest of the series.
And on the visiting side, starting pitching is always the big key in a game like this to kick off a series.
Yeah, you need a strong performance on the mound. That's the number one way to cancel out the home field edge we just mentioned.
First pitch coming your way next. About to get started here for game one. Today's starting pitcher, Cy Young.
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working.
Now it's the shortstop, Derek Jeter. This guy is one of the best athletes in the sport. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Ball one there.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there are certain times the ball.
Runner on the go. There's a ball. Throw. Safe. Posada too late with the throw. Singy, he definitely showed off the wheels there.
Yeah, and it turned out to be a bang-bang play. StatCast gives us the data, and that stolen base was impossible without that sprint speed.
2-0. Up the middle, Peraza. On to first. One gone, bottom half of the first.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Bay.
Here comes Gleyber Torres.
The designated hitter, Gleyber Torres.
And now it's 1-2. Grounder might be two. To second, there's one. On to first, out, double play. Just got it there in time. So first and second with two outs. The batter now, Derek Jeter. He's 0-for-1.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
Hammered, and this one could be extra bases. Here comes Biggio around third. One run is in, right, headed for the plate. He's also in to score, and they lead by four. In there safely.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one, ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in the mechanics.
Babe Ruth, his first at bat was a strikeout. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
The 1-2. Ground ball, left side. Now the throw to first on the run. Inning over, and it could have been worse. Three runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. We play two full. The Thunder lead it 5-1. Ow. First and second, one out. And the batter now, Reggie Jackson. One for one with a single so far. Oh, and that liner got him. To second, there's one. Oh, he throws it away. And this ball's going to wind up out of play. So a big-time costly mistake there.
Mickey.
Two outs, nobody on. Here's a speed threat. Derek Jeter. There's a strike. Well, Singy, Derek Jeter turned out to be a pretty good first-round pick by the Yankees in 1992. Sixth overall. Remember, he struggled defensively in the minors, but debuted in 1995, helped lead the Yankees to a world championship in 1996. The wind of the pitch. Flares it into the outfield. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. One gone, runner at first. And now the DH, Gleyber Torres.
Turn two,
right here. Here we go.
On the ground, could be two. Jeter tossed to second. On to first, double play. And that's the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. To the bottom of the sixth inning, the Thunder have the lead, 7-3. When I come out, they run out. I'll be working that stage to the sun out. Your boy get them thrown up. Time to lace my boots and show up. And stepping in is the speedy Derek Jeter. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. There's a strike.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
One down, base is empty. This ball's chopped on the ground. Peraza whips it to first. And there are two down.
The batter, number three, designated hitter, Bay.
And stepping now in for the Yankees, Alfonso Soriano. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports, too. Up the middle, Jeter gathers and throws to first. Play is made, two out.
Now batter, third baseman, Wade Boggs.
Three, he's out. That's ball four. Three. Out.
Next to hit, Derek
the
Jeter.
Batter, number two, shortstop, Derek.
Montas a move to first, and he's back in safely.
Hey, get your pitch. No one better up there.
First pitch, not close.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
Ripped on a line, and that should be extra bases. And that's going to roll to the wall right around third. He will score, and they lead by three. Not in time. He's safe.
He quickly went from hitter to base runner. Love when guys make that transition, and he's got speed to put on a show.
Third, two gone. And here is Babe Ruth. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. Righty delivers. This one lifted in the air, left field. Jackson brings it in for the third out. A run on two hits, and they leave one. Through eight full, the Thunder out front here, 8-5.
It's pretty early in this series to say a must-win game, but when you've got home field advantage, it's a luxury, but you have to protect it. Huge win in game one to set the tone.
So, Chris, here's a look at the final numbers from what turned out to be a really close ball game.
Yeah, this is one of those games that clearly could have gone either way, and that's kind of exactly what you expect out of postseason baseball. So competitive.
And a final, 8-7. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
Our final line score. First, for your victorious home team, 8 runs, 9 hits, 1 error, and 13 bunts.
Inside the Show. And now your host, Justin Allegri.
Nation's capital, we welcome you inside Griffith Stadium. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the New York Yankees taking on Palm Beach. John Ciambi along with Chris Singleton, and a lot riding on this one as these teams meet for game two, Chris.
Yeah, this might be the game to actually decide the series, Boo. When it's five games, getting a 2-0 lead is a dominant position to be in, and I don't see this series getting to a fifth game if we have a repeat of game one's outcome in this one.
Yeah, the crows start circling for a team that falls into a two-game deficit, not where you want to be. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set to go now. And today's starting pitcher, Babe Ruth. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is
one down. And now the veteran third baseman, Wade Boggs. He's a left-handed batter who still comes up with good contact and a good average against left-handed pitchers. That's out to center field. Trout is there. Makes the grab. Two down.
Batting third.
Four. Take your base. Three.
Here's Gleyber Torres.
The designated hitter.
Torres, a guy the Yankees acquired for Aroldis Chapman back in 2016.
He is fearless. You can't tell if he's been in this league for 8 years or 2 years.
And a base hit.
I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Bottom half of inning number two, and now batting Mike Trout. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Guidry back to work. Swing and a miss. And that is strike one. Guidry, a former Cy Young Award winner. He features a slider, a four-seamer, a two-seamer, and he occasionally uses a curve. And that one finds its way through. So a man on base to start the inning. Here's the veteran first baseman, Don Mattingly, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. Step off throw to first, and diving back is Trout. Another move to first, and he's back again. Again to first, and no luck this time either. Pickoff throw once again, and a shocking development. He's safe again. This one in the air right field. Judge is under it. Squeezes it, and there's one away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
The right fielder, Andre.
So up next, Andre Dawson. The 1-2. Can't connect on the curveball, struck him out.
Well, he didn't get the call on the mound the pitch before. Felt like he should have had him looking, I think. But, you know, that's good composure right there. He found a way to come back with another good pitch to get him to swing and miss.
Trout, the runner at first with two gone. Ripped to third, but handled, and that'll end the inning. So one out, nobody on. And now big number 99, Aaron Judge, went down on strikes his first time through. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. In the air out to center, Trout settles under it, pulls it down, and he makes the catch. Two down.
Up next for the Yankees, the catcher.
He's out. Three. He's back.
Back to the top of the lineup. Now here is Alfonso Soriano. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Runner leads away at second. On a line, base hit. Peraza around third. He scores, and the lead is up to five.
Well done. Drives in the run. Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive into center field. So that definitely felt good.
And stepping in for the Yankees, Lou Gehrig. This guy has turned into a beast. In the air, center field. Trout is there. Puts it away for the out.
You're out. Three.
Here's Mike Trout. Picked up a base hit to center his first time up.
Mike Trout.
Foul ball there.
Mike Trout, just a special player, a special human, does everything well on the baseball field and seems to do it as well off the field.
Strike two. I think with Mike Trout, when you consider all the awards, the wins above replacement, he's on a trajectory, if he stays healthy, that he'll end up as one of the greatest position players of all time. Off the mark there, and that is ball one.
One of the unfortunate things is that in this guy's career, particularly early, we just didn't get to see him in the postseason very much. You want to see?
Makes the catch, inning over. Stepping in now for the Yankees, Oswald Peraza, one for two.
Peraza.
And a pitch. And that one lifted in the air center field. That's a base hit, run scores. And they hold the runner at third. Bases remain loaded here. Still only one gone.
Still able to come through behind in the count right there. Pitch was in and off the plate. So hard to do anything with the pitch in that location, but somehow he got the barrel to it and hit it well. Pretty amazing.
Runner at first with two away. Mickey Mantle stepping in now for the Yankees. Year in and year out, this guy an MVP candidate. The 1-2. Out of line, out towards center. Makes the play, and it's out number three. So in the end, 10 men come to the plate. Six of them come around to score. Home half of the fifth coming up. The Yankees. One out, base is empty. And now the switch hitting catcher, Jorge Posada. He's already homered in this game. One down, base is empty. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And it's a double, making him 3-for-4 on the day.
These guys today are so great with handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
Now Trout gets a chance to hit. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Great speed and great power. A great athlete, quite simply. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. To the left center, base hit. Jeter coming home. One run across. Runner holds at third, so just one across on the play. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
So digging in, Don Mattingly.
Number 23. Mattingly.
1-2 now. And that one hit to first. Out number two, and another run comes in.
Your boys bringing the bars back with the force of Star Wars. Medicine walking all black. Where's your heart at?
Two outs with a man at third. Andre Dawson now at the plate. He's a guy, Chris's highlights include some of the best throws from the outfield that you will ever see. Definitely one of the best arms in the sport. On the ground to third. In time to Gehrig. That's the inning. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. We head to the seventh now in game two. The Yankees lead it 12-2. And it's second with one away. Here's Trout.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
Ball one, no strikes.
One ball, no strikes.
Ruth over at second, one down. Can't glove it cleanly to first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
Now back, first baseman, John Mattingly.
And now the first baseman, John Mattingly. And he steps off. And now he steps off the rubber.
It's a pitch and drive. Let's go, big dog.
And a 3-2. On the ground, right side. In time to Gehrig. Got him.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And now here is Andre Dawson, 1-for-3. This is a true five-tool guy. Not very many of them out there, but when he's on the field, you can't take your eye off of him. 0-2 now. In the air, fairly deep to right field. That is the inning.
In the postseason is to split on the road and play very well at home. They did just that with the win today, evening up at 1-1.
Well, Singy, it wasn't pretty, but here's another look at the final line.
Yeah, Boog, this one wasn't close. Not a lot of drama at the end either, and you just don't see a lot of blowouts in the postseason.
And your final, 12-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 43 minutes.
I've been lost in your eyes all afternoon. The more I drift, the closer I get to you.
Inside the show. And now your host, Justin Allegri.
Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for...
The crowd is electric, and we'll be back to get it going right after this. Welcome in, baseball fans, and here in New York, MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's Palm Beach taking on the New York Yankees. John Ciambi, Chris Singleton with you. We're looking forward to what's sure to be a dramatic Game 3, Chris.
Man, it's been fun so far, Boog, that's for sure. After splitting the first two, Game 3 takes on even more meaning than usual. You don't want to be the team that drops this one and then be faced with having to win two games in a row in order to take the series. That's tough.
And the pressure on the starting pitchers is big in this one. Each of them is being counted on to come through with a quality performance, hoping to save some of that bullpen for really critical games coming up. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Ready to get underway, and today's starter, Carlos Rodon.
Yeah, and when he's on, he's a real treat to watch. I become a fan myself. You know, he often takes the pressure off of his hitters to score a lot of runs, but they have to be careful to not just go into a slumber. They've got to put up some runs, make it a little bit easier for this guy.
Bottom of the first, and stepping in for the Yankees, Alfonso Soriano. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. Swing and a high fly ball, pretty well struck right field. That's back there, and it's gone! He rockets one to right, and they're chipping away. It's 2-1.
Scary for a pitcher when a guy can take a fastball down the middle and hit it to the opposite field. No holes in a swing like that, and that time that ball was hit hard.
Just Wade Boggs now, and the first pitch misses for ball one. Willis, the former rookie of the year, he features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a changeup, a cutter, and he occasionally uses a curve.
The real threats are coming up, already giving up a home run in this inning. He's going to really have to bear down.
That misses. Now two balls and a strike.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
That misses, and now it's 3-2. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Left-hand batter waits. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
So up next, Lou Gehrig. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. And Gehrig hit cleanup for that famed murderer's row lineup, as the Yankees were rolling off one World Series title after another. 0-2 as he waves at that one.
Gehrig hit behind Babe Ruth in those murderer's row days. They both have tons of power, but their home runs had much different trajectories.
0-2 now. Swing and a ball lifted left field.
You got it.
Davis hauls it in, and there's one away.
Batting four.
No left field. Now, Reggie Jackson. Big time power.
Jackson.
And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. Boggs stands at first with one out.
Hey, let's go right here.
Next pitch is outside. And now 2-2.
Sometimes being lucky is a swing and miss. If he makes contact with that pitch, probably hits into a double play.
Got him swinging for the strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Mickey Mantle in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
Next offering is in for a strike. And here it comes. That one misses. And the count 1-2.
1-2.
That's down and in. Now all even up. On the ground to third. They take the force out. That ends the inning. So a run on one hit, no errors, and a man left. We go on to inning number two. The Thunder out front 2-1. We head to the bottom of the second, and stepping in for the Yankees, Aaron Judge. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average, but one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties, and that's through there for a strike. They're so reliant on the matchups nowadays, Chris, and it's huge when you don't have to sit a guy or platoon him.
When you can hit, you know, both sides in terms of pitcher's arms, you're a guy that it's hard to take out of the lineup, and I think it's very important today when everything is under the microscope.
Hit hard, that gets through.
I'd say a mistake pitch in an 0-2 count. Too good of a pitch to hit right there. You have to expand the zone. Keep that leadoff man off first base.
And now, Jorge Posada. Close, but call the ball, and it's 2-0. That one finds the zone. Now 2-1.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back.
Jeter over to second. Relay to first. Double play.
Batting it, the designated hitter. Labor. Torres.
Labor Torres up to the plate. There's a strike. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
He wanted that fastball high and tight, looking for a strikeout, just didn't locate it very well.
Sets him down looking. A controversial called strike 3 to end the inning. Here at New Yankee Stadium in the Bronx, and the batter will be the shortstop, Oswald Peraza. Peraza getting to start at shortstop, hitting ninth in today's lineup, and he was born in Venezuela. And first offering is fouled off.
Some of the greatest players in the history of the game were born in Venezuela, including one that finished with 500-plus home runs, 3,000-plus hits, and a triple crown.
The wind of the pitch. Foul ball. It stays nothing in two. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out.
tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out when they're on the mound, because if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it could take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence, and it's a multi-run home run.
Now it's going to be Alfonso Soriano. One down, base is empty. Swing and a ground ball off the middle. That's a base hit.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
And now Wade Boggs. In there, and it's 0-1. Boggs measures 6 feet 2 inches, 195 pounds, and he was awarded a gold glove. Fires to second for one. What a double play that was. Inning over. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. 3 innings complete. The Thunder on top here, 3-1. At Yankee Stadium, stepping in, Luke Gehrig.
The first baseman.
Goes without saying, one of the biggest legends of the game here in Gehrig. Probably the greatest first baseman of all time.
That one's in there. That's strike one. In 1929, Gehrig slashed 300, 431, 584. Not too bad, right? Well, that was maybe the worst season of his career. Tells you about what kind of player he was.
The left fielder, Reggie.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Reggie Jackson. First offering, and it just misses. On the ground, right side. Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Everyone's trying to elevate the ball in today's game, but if you can hit a ball that hard on the ground, it's going to find some holes.
Runner on at first with one gone. And stepping in for the Yankees, Mickey Mantle. Ball one, no strikes. And a strike in there. The pitch. Swings through that one.
Clearly was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Davis has it sized up and puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two. Here is Aaron Judge. One for one. He singled the left his first time through. Reggie on the run. Pitch misses. And that's a stolen base. Not even close.
Well, that steal right there is wanting to take advantage of having a really good hitter at the plate. Now they've got a much better shot at bringing home a two-out RBI.
Two outs and one in scoring position. Next offering is in for a strike. Chris Judge has been an exit velocity monster, leading the league in exit velo in 17, 18, 19, 21, and 2022.
Yeah, he makes that hot corner at third base.
2-1 on Judge. And he takes a strike.
I think he was sitting off speed right there because he just let the fastball go by.
That one missing inside. Jorge Posada waiting on deck if they extend the inning.
Plenty of pop in his bat, so he could give them the lead with one swing if he gets the chance.
Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. 3-2. Swings through it for the K. Pulled the string on the changeup.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
back in the Bronx, John Chavi with my buddy Chris Singleton, and set to get us started. Bottom five, Jorge Posada.
And a foul ball. You know, these Yankees need to bring up the quality of their bats and specifically their swings. Just one extra base hit for them, so they haven't exactly been hitting the ball gap to gap or out of the park. That makes it really difficult to generate runs.
The 0-2. Gets a piece and stays alive. The wind and the pitch. That misses the zone, and that's ball one. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Snuck the fastball by him.
Now back.
Gleyber Torres up to hit. Struck out looking at his first at bat. Swing and a bouncer. Close play, but in there. Man at first with one gone. Oswald Peraza stepping in now for the Yankees. And that's in there for strike one. Torres, the base runner at first with one out. Gonna count 1-2.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
On the ground, two ball. Biggio to second, and that's two. One hit in the inning, but no one left. We're through five. The Thunder have the advantage, 3-1. Music make me smile. Some people call it rhythm and soul. Bottom of the sixth inning. Here's the Yankees leadoff hitter, Alfonso Soriano. On the ground, the first. Mattingly steps on the bag, one away, bottom of the sixth.
Up next for the Yankees, the third baseman, Wade.
Now at the plate, Wade Boggs. Singing four homers in 22 games at Old Yankee Stadium. What do you remember?
Well, I remember my rookie year hitting two in one game. And, you know, before that game in the clubhouse, there was a gentleman there who owned a suit company there in downtown Manhattan. And he said to me, "Hey, kid, you hit a home run in the game tonight. Come over to the store tomorrow and I'll give you a free suit."
Dives, what a play.
Oh, this is an all-in effort right here. Going back on it, knows that the outfielder's not going to get there, lays out and makes a tremendous catch. What a great job of picking up his pitcher.
Two outs, base is empty. And stepping in for the Yankees, Lou Gehrig. And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
So I went into the game. I happened to hit two. When I walked into the store the next day, and he looked at me, he said, "You're trying to put me out of business, aren't you?" And that was a great, great experience that I had as a rookie playing against the Yankees, playing in New York.
Two down, nobody on. Swings and crushes one. Right field, way back, and gone. His second home run of the series, and they slice into the lead. It's 4-2.
Got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ball game.
Base is empty with two away. Now here's the Yankees cleanup hitter, Reggie Jackson. That one's in there. That's strike one. So did Super Joe give you two suits?
Super Joe hooked me up with two suits.
The next pitch misses. And one and one. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. What a stop! The throw, and they get the out.
This guy's anticipation is off the charts. Don't see many shortstops better than that. Great job to complete the play and end the inning.
Back here in New York, and here is Mickey Mantle. The Yankees in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at-bat out of him right here.
And a strike. The Yankees looking to rally. There's a strike. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Next pitch misses inside, and the count is 1-2. Good eye right there.
No, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed, it's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Judge in the box again, takes a strike.
Well, impressed that he went right after him on that first pitch. That's the key. Try to get ahead in the count, then you can play around a little bit more as the at-bat expands.
There comes an 0-2 to Judge.
One ball, two strikes.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
Hard hit, right side. Mattingly takes it himself. Two up, two down.
Now back. The catcher.
Two outs, bases empty. Jorge Posada stepping in now for the Yankees. Swing and a tapper. Sanchez fires over to first, and that is the inning. Down in order, go the Yankees. They still trail it here. It's 6-2. Back for more from the Bronx. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here is Gleyber Torres. Willis back to work. And that one is in for a strike. And a swing and a miss there.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Struck him out looking. Froze him with the heater at the knees.
Well, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way coming from that opposite arm angle. So I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
And now the shortstop, Oswald Peraza. Out there to center.
Ball.
Puts the squeeze on that one, and there's two down. So the lineup flips over. Here's the Yankees leadoff hitter, Alfonso Soriano. He's already homered here in this one. That one's in there, 0-1.
Oh, he's got to be pretty proud of this outing so far. Sometimes guys cower coming into a ballpark like this, but he has attacked hitters. Pitching on the road like this is very impressive. This has been a treat to watch.
And he deals. In the air, right field. And puts the squeeze on that. And that is that.
He's out. Three. That's
game threes are very critical when you have a series tied at 1-1 because you put yourself up. Anytime you go down, you're always chasing. When you're up in the series, you feel like you're in the driver's seat. Nice win today.
Your final 6-2 for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
Never lost it all and had to get it all back. It's got me looking back and everything was all mad. You gotta know the roads and know when to fall back. This time I want it all and it ain't all chat. Oh man, my mommy took my chain and where I'm pawned at. Life's like a movie, I record that. Dad was in jail, so I grew up calling poor dad. Sitting in my cell with a... Everybody's active, play your part, no slacking. Everybody's playing their position, that's the day I'm wishing. Caught up in the system, ain't no way of living. Sick of kittens, sick of seeing cats. It's a catch, we in a trap. Never loved the roles, cause they won't love you back. My young G's love to trap, like Kodak. She got a monkey on her back. And if I robbed you, then you won't get no money back.
It's a lesson, you're living life, then that's a blessing.
Fans are final line score.
Inside the Show. And now your host, Justin Allegri.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Inside the Show, your source for all postseason news. Here's a recap of yesterday's playoff baseball. In Game 3 of the AL Division Series, the Thunder totaled 11 hits as they took down the Yankees in the Bronx, 6-2. They take a 2-1 series lead into Game 4. For Game 3 of the ALDS, the Angels got the win against the visiting Guardians, 3-2. They trail in the series 1-2 going into Game 4. In Game 4 of the National League Division Series, the Los Angeles Dodgers grabbed 13 hits in the game as they got past the Reds in Cincinnati, 6-1. They've now tied the series at 2 heading into Game 5. For Game 4 of the NL Division Series, the Braves amassed 14 hits in the game as they got the win over the Giants in San Francisco, clinching the series and earning their right to play in the National League Championship Series. Thanks for tuning in today. We'll be back here tomorrow and all postseason long.